for strange experiments that shocked the whole world. In the 19th century, electricity became the new fascination of scientists. Seen at the time as a magical force worthy of study, electricity came to be used in many strange experiments. Hoping to bring the bodies of the dead back to life, eccentric scientists have used the most bizarre methods to defy the normal course of nature. In 1818, a 20-year-old woman named Mary Shelley published her first novel under a pseudonym entitled Frankenstein, or the Modern Prometheus. The book told the story of a mad scientist who reanimated a corpse and created a monster. Although it is a story, Shelley's story is not very different from what happened in the laboratories of the 19th and 20th centuries. At that time, many important scientists were hard at work on strange experiments. Here are some of the most interesting. Weird experiments: Luigi Galvani, frog legs and electric shocks. Electrical resuscitation was an old idea when Mary Shelley began writing her famous novel. A few decades earlier, in 1780, the great Italian scientist Luigi Galvani had observed a phenomenon that would lead him down the path of strange experiments. In that year, Galvani was a lecturer at the University of Bologna. At that time, scientists were not necessarily specialized, and Galvani was interested in everything. He was a chemist, physicist, anatomist, and philosopher at the same time. Moreover, he seemed to excel at everything. In 1780, Galvani had been head of the Department of Obstetrics for more than 12 years. At the same time, he had done extensive research on animal vision and hearing. When research stagnated in those two areas, Galvani turned his attention to frogs' legs. Here's the legend that later grew around his research. Galvani was skinning the underside of a frog when his assistant's scalpel touched a bronze hook in the frog's flesh. Suddenly, the leg twitched as if it was trying to hop. Galvani came up with ideas. The scientist published the result of these strange experiments in 1780, along with a new theory. According to this theory, the muscles of corpses contained a vital fluid, which Galvani called animal electricity. The scientist believed that the electrical fluid left in the animal's legs was reactivated upon contact with electricity. This theory gave rise to a real controversy with the scientist Alessandro Volta. Although he had initially confirmed the result of Galvani's strange experiments, Volta later denied his theory. An electric shock was an electric shock, Volta argued. To prove this, he invented a powerful electric battery. With her help, he subjected numerous corpses to electric shocks to prove that Galvani had only discovered a simple effect of electric current. Strange experiments, bringing a hanged criminal back to life. By the time Volta built the first voltaic batteries, Galvani was too old to try to defend his theories. This mission fell to his nephew, Giovanni Aldini, who did not shy away from strange experiments. On January 18, 1803, convict George Forster, of London, was hanged. The court had found him guilty of drowning his wife and child in a canal. Forster died quickly, and the body was transported to Giovanni Aldini's laboratory. He had moved to the Newgate neighborhood to be close to the scaffolding located in the area. Aldini quickly summoned several medical students, as well as various curious ones, and began to work with the corpse. First, he moved his limbs and struck him in the face to prove that Forster was indeed dead. He then washed the corpse's ears with salt water and inserted sponges into them to ensure conductivity. Finally, he placed an electrode in each ear and turned on the electric current. When the current first passed through the face, the corpse's jaws began to tremble. The surrounding muscles were horribly contorted and one eye was open. Next, his right hand was raised. His fist clenched. Then, his legs and thighs were set in motion, said a reporter who witnessed the demonstration, horrified. To the onlookers, it probably seemed that Aldini was bringing the murderer back to life, an unsettling thought for many people. The concern was so great that even the governors came to wonder what to do if Forster had been resurrected. The consensus was that the murderer should have been hanged a second time. These strange experiments of Aldini's had become well known in London, and his uncle's ideas about animal electricity were beginning to seem credible. Andrew Ure, the Scotsman who experimented in public. Andrew Ure was finishing his studies around the time Aldini was experimenting with the corpses of convicts. Ure was a young Scottish scientist, one of those geniuses interested in all fields. Ure had just graduated from university and was looking for a field of study. He found Aldini's strange experiments fascinating and decided to try them too. By 1818, Ure already had a steady stream of freshly hanged criminals to work on. Britain had no shortage of executions. There were around 300 crimes punishable by death, so Ure was very busy. Unlike today's researchers, Ure liked his experiments to be seen by a large number of people. These sinister public performances earned him a reputation as a wizard of science. Like Aldini, he had specialized in applying electric shocks to various parts of the body to make them move. As with Aldini, the scientific validity of the experiments was questionable. That's because Ure didn't seem to be answering any particular questions through his experiments. However, apparently they were scary. Every muscle in the body was immediately agitated with convulsive movements. They resembled the violent shaking caused by cold. When he moved the second electrode from the thigh to the heel, the leg twitched violently. He almost knocked over an assistant who was trying to stop the move. The corpse also made the movements associated with breathing by stimulating the phrenic nerve and the diaphragm. When the supraorbital nerve was activated, every muscle in the face began a terrifying movement: anger, fear, despair, anguish, and sinister smiles. They all showed their hideous expressions on the criminal's face. At this point, several spectators left the room in horror or disgust, and one gentleman fainted. Strange experiments, attempts from the 20th century. The work of scientists who studied the relationship between organisms and electricity was set aside after 1820. Even Ure abandoned his work, then taking up other fields and sliding further down the religious slope. But things took a new turn in 20th century Russia. In the early 1920s, a Russian scientist was again researching this field. This time, the strange experiments also gave results. Russian researcher Sergei Brunenko invented a primitive heart-lung pump called an autoinjector. These still exist today, and Brunenko's model was essentially correct. But the way he tested it is sinister. In one of his first strange experiments, Brunenko decapitated a dog and immediately connected it to his machine. The gear took the blood from the veins and passed it through a filter for oxygenation. According to his report, Brunenko kept the dog's severed head alive for over an hour and a half. Then the blood clots that formed led to the death of the dog. These strange experiments were documented in the 1940 film Experiments in the Reanimation of Organisms. Although reanimation had not yet succeeded, the Russian scientist's stated goal was to reanimate all fallen soldiers for the country. According to the Soviet Science Committee, Brunenko allegedly succeeded in doing it in 1930. The scientist was allegedly entrusted with the body of a man who had committed suicide a few hours ago. Brunenko allegedly connected him to the auto-injector and injected a mixture of chemicals into his blood while the chest cavity was open. Members of Brunenko's team claimed they had succeeded in restarting the man's heart. The story goes that they were able to get a stable heart rate. Then the deceased would have started growling, at which point the scientists got scared and stopped the experiment. Of course, we will never know if this story is true or not, but coming from the Soviet Union, it would be more prudent to consider it richly embellished.